thought I will share with you a story about what this transfer of learning and impact is. So this is a conversation that we had with our senior management team, including Anand, because we had just launched RISE in 2010. And the organization was rebranding itself. And the question, therefore, before was that, how should we be a learning partner? Because if we are not a learning partner, and if we do not create impact for the management team and the various businesses, how do you expect our partners to really do that? So the challenge before us was that we had created a new core purpose. Our earlier core purpose was very Indian in nature. It spoke of Indians are second to none, and we will be known globally for the quality of our products and services. The new core purpose that evolved was around the theme of RISE. It was all about that we will challenge conventional thinking and innovatively use all our resources to drive positive change in the lives of our stakeholders and communities across the world to RISE. If that be the core theme that is pervading in the 17 billion federation of companies. One thing we have got to understand, our organization structure is a highly empowered structure. And we have got to create an influence framework if we have got to really create a dent in the organization. That's the biggest challenge that we had. And since all our businesses were very independent, how do we therefore bring this learning agenda on top of the platform? So luckily for us, we had also created a new aspiration by that. By 2011, we had a new aspiration in line with our core purpose that we will be amongst the top 50 most admired global brands by enabling people across the world to RISE. Therefore, there are two things that we have got to look at. We have got to ensure that our learning is focused towards building the brand, which means it's more from an admired point of view. It's not about the profit, the top line, whatever. These things are absolutely essential. Right? They are the basics for any business to be there. But how do you create admiration, everything that you really do? And that should help people in terms of challenge conventional thinking, which means they should be able to look out of the box, break the mold. They should be able to look at things very, very innovatively and very, very different. And whatever we do, it should impact some or most of our stakeholders. If we do things that do not impact our stakeholders, then really has no meaning. So because we have to look at our customer, therefore we have to have an outside-in approach. We must look at our channel partners that we work with, and we must also look at our industry community and the employees at large. Therefore, we said that take the brand per se, when it speaks to the customers outside, we have got what is known as a customer value proposition. Therefore, whatever learning agenda we create, it should foster the building of the customer value proposition across the diverse federation of companies that we are in. And internally, we have got to ensure that we have a powerful employee value proposition. We really didn't have to define the employee value proposition because our core purpose itself was the employee value proposition. It spoke of what type of people we need and what type of experiences we are able to provide for them. And how do we really bring this? So we had a conversation with all the senior leaders, etc. And we said, if you have got to really do this, we have got to aggregate all the federated best practices and new emerging thoughts into something which we can really create. So therefore, we created what is known as the Mahindra Leadership University. Right? And this is where I would show you. So then we said, if you have got to have a leadership university, then we must be able to get expectations. In a diverse federation, getting a buy-in is the most difficult thing. Therefore, we created a governing council. Right? And this governing council is chaired by Anand Mahindra, and I'm the member secretary for that. And we have got all our group presidents who come together. And we therefore then articulate that if we have got to leave our core purpose and meet our aspiration, what are things that we have got to do? So then we realize that we have got to break it up into academies. Right? So then we said that we would have two academies that would run across. So we have the Innovation Academy, which will foster the culture of innovation. And we have got the Academy of Leadership Development, which would work across the whole spectrum of the group. And then we said that depending upon the business that we are in, we would create business-related academies. So we had, for the manufacturing, we had a set of academies which was more manufacturing-oriented. Then we had the IT business, which is primarily develops itself through domain capabilities that you build it. Right? Because we operate across the spectrum with acquisition of Satyam, Tech Mahindra became a very dominant force in the IT industry. And therefore, we had to ensure that we have a set of academies in the IT industry which caters to all the domain areas that we are. We are in banking, we are in finance, we are in petrochemicals, we are in pharmaceuticals. Entire solution architecture, people should be able to really provide. So therefore, we created these academies. And we said that whatever we do, it has to have a set of values. So therefore, we said that we have got the RISE principles. So anything what an academy does, it has to be in line with the RISE principles, which is accept no limit, alternative thinking, and driving positive change. So that gave us what is the expectation that we have. And then we had a set of leadership competencies, because in a diverse federation, you must have an architecture with which you are able to really work. Otherwise, our ability to deliver and execute would become very, very different. So we said that leadership competencies would be another thing which everybody would have to follow. And then we have got the core purpose and core values. So we said whatever we do, it cannot be outside our core purpose and core values. And be it domain capability, be it an innovation culture, be it a functional capability that you are building, or be it a behavioral capability, it has to ensure that there is a touch of the Mahindra way in the whole thing. Therefore, this is how we said that if we have got to create a transfer of learning, there has to be an architecture in place for that. That's the first thing that we did. Now, when you have got set up all the academies, etc., we said that there has to be a way by which, because these things will not be done by us. So we got an excellent, so we had a SAP package which was not working for us at all. Therefore, we tied up with some total and we put an integrated learning platform across the whole group. So entire learning is now with a line of sight. With one click, anybody across the group can have access to what's the type of programs that is there. And we said we should empower people to really choose the type of programs. So people have a way by which they can create programs which is organization driven, or curate programs which are individual driven. So I shared with you end a framework that really happens. Therefore, this is the framework we said that if you have got a criticality in terms of a capability, right, we should have it from a desirable, essential and vital. And then we should say that what is the mastery level that we want. Therefore, we said that all knowledge programs should be transferred into an e-learning platform. Right? And therefore, we work with partners who help us to develop e-learning modules across domain academies. Right? That is what I've got my colleague Naushad, who is the dean of our Mahindra Leadership University and his team, who actually work with all the businesses to ensure that entire knowledge is translated into an e-learning industry. It's an exercise that we started about 3 to 4 years back. It's an ongoing one. And the programs that we run, apart from that, which is based on a 3E principle, which is experience, exposure, and education, right? Those will be very few. So you cannot run too many programs. This is what we realized. We did a benchmark across this thing, and we realized that our programs have to be behavior-focused. If you do not know what behavior you want to change, there is no change that will happen. Therefore, any program that we have got a key behavior that we want to really change, and then we use a 3 model to bring. So this is one framework that we created, and therefore the expectations are very clear as to how do you develop a module and how do you translate the module. Then we said that if you are a large, you've got 200,000 people across the group, you've got 100 companies, how do you ensure that there is some sort of a uniformity in which that we are able to develop. So we translated the whole. So we removed hierarchy out of it. You may have grades of different type. As we said, we are not bothered about grades, we are bothered about roles. So we translated the whole thing into a role matrix. So we split the entire population into 5 role matrix space. And we said that at role matrix 5 and 4, we use the Kahn's model typically. It will be more in terms of behaviors. And role matrix 1 and 2 would focus more in terms of functional capabilities. Right? And the academies would focus in more in role matrix 1, 2, and 3. And the role matrix 4 and 5 would be more behavior focused. They are responsible for creating the ecosystem and creating systems and processes for change to really happen. Therefore, then we said, okay, what's the type of people that we have to partner with? Therefore, we partnered with Harvard. We partnered with Ross School of Business Management. We have partnered with IMD Lausanne. And we have partnered with the Yale School of Management and Center for Creative Leadership. So we put a series of programs And we made it very clear for them, okay, what's the type of program. We created talent management architecture, so our partners know, okay, what's the type of program. And we are also clear, because we are also a learning partner, and we coach our senior leaders as to how is it that they should be spearheading the learning agenda and the learning philosophy of the organization. And then we said, for the Academy of Leadership Development, right, we have got all the senior leaders across the group. We just created a framework as to what a laddered approach would mean. And then we said all the academies will have to ensure that this laddered approach to learning, because if I want to climb a staircase and go to the fourth floor, right, unless I am a Superman, I can just fly. But not everybody is Superman, you know. So you have got to climb the stairs one by one and then go up. Therefore we said you have to have a philosophy that if you've got to build capability, and we are in businesses where domain capability is absolutely essential. It takes 3 years to develop a vehicle. With digitization, we can bring it down to 12 to 15 months. And therefore, the way we build capability, there has to be a science behind it. Right? And therefore, we have got to have a curated form by which capability is really built, and a created form by which we are able to ensure that what is needed is really brought into the organization. Therefore, this is one thing that we did. And then we said that if in a large a business like ours, if we have got to really grow, then we must have some structured interventions that should happen. Therefore, we said that, and since we are federated, we have got to ensure that we bring collaboration. Therefore, we said at a group level, we will focus only at two sets of people who contribute about 30% of our total population. And the businesses, we will contribute, we'll work with 70% of the people. And we said that we should have a pipeline approach to leadership development. And therefore, we said that this entire Mahindra Leadership University should be like a platform. Therefore, we get learning providers and learning seekers together. And that is what Naushad and this team does, is they operate like a platform. They help to connect the larger mass of people who want to build capability. And then they aggregate together a set of learning partners. And then they provide it to the constituents who want to learn. That's a typical shift that we have created. Earlier, what we used to do was, we used to create a program and push it down in the funnel. Right? And people were forced to accept it whether they liked it or not. And we said that if you have got to create a learning impact, then we should be able to know what people want, and we should be able to know what capabilities we have. And therefore, Naushad, as a part of his role, has to ensure that his team acts like an aggregator and a segregator and ensures deployment of relevant learning interventions across the organization. And therefore, they partner with, we have a team of about 400-500 people across the thing. So, and nobody reports to anybody. Hierarchy is something which we have been able to break after a long time. And therefore, everybody has to influence the other as to how you really make this happen. Therefore, you put a set of dynamic councils and business intervention specialists who ensure that this whole thing is brought into this. Therefore, if you look at it, at a strategic band, we have a program which is tied up with IMD Lausanne, which we call the Future Leaders Program, where the top 34 people across the group go, and where everybody, we have created an ecosystem for this to really work. We have got a set of coaches who really work with this set of people. We have got a set of mentors. The first intervention that we have tried, we're trying to create an ecosystem for leadership development. And we say that, what does the future mean? We say that today we are a 17 billion. And in the next 5 to 6 years, we should be around 50 to 100 billion US dollars. And we have got to provide such a massive growth which is required. And we need a architecture and an institution which will help to provide this leadership pipeline. And then we have got a pipeline which fills the Future Leaders Program, where we have tied up with the Ross School of Business Management. They do a series of interventions for ensuring that we create a pipeline of future leaders. And down the line, we have got several interventions, which is multi-pronged interventions. We work with the top B schools to ensure that we create a pipeline. Each of our businesses create an emerging leaders program so that we are able to create a pipeline which helps to fill this big demand of leaders that we really require. And this is a framework that we have really put in place to make things happen. And we said that one of the greatest things we realized was that coaching was something that was really required. And you have got to have coaches who are built within the organization. And this was the biggest gap that we had, because we participated in an Aon Hewitt survey for top companies for leaders to work for. And we came amongst the top 10 companies across the world. And we realized that one of the key strengths that we had was a program called the Reflective Conversation. So Reflective Conversation is nothing but using skills of coaching, but we realized that coaching had a deficiency syndrome in the Indian context. So whenever we said that a leader has to get into a coaching thing, he said, what is wrong with me? He said, nothing is wrong with you at all. So then we realized that we have got to break this whole thing. And luckily for us, Anand Mahindra had also come out with a context in one of our senior leaders' meet that we have got to create a reflective organization. Therefore, we tagged on this and we said that how can we create a reflective conversation for building a reflective organization. It used the basic skills of active listening, asking powerful questions, giving and receiving feedback, integrated with intuition, imagination, metaphors, etc. And we put the whole organization. So this is a program they said that if you have got to be a top 50 most admired brand, then how leaders connect with leaders, how leaders connect with larger mass of employees becomes very, very crucial. Therefore, we have put a process in place, and therefore this is an expectation that came up from the senior managers, either from the senior leadership team, that this is what we want to really create. Whatever you do, you have got to focus in terms of admiration. So we had thousands of programs, we are actually eliminating many of those, and we said that have few. This is what we realized, that we go to Google or you go to Microsoft, etc. They don't do too many things. They do a few things, but do it extremely well. Therefore, we said that we have got to create a focus. Bhavna is here. So we said that in the context of a RISE, when you do, you need a 360 degree feedback, which is totally customized. We had the best of consultants across the world who came and told us that we said, no, we need a 360 degree feedback which connects with us. And therefore, we partnered with her and we created a RISE 360 leadership framework. So we said that if you are a RISE leader, right, what do people think of you demonstrating the three pillars of RISE? And then we said that there are five, all of us have leadership competencies. You take any leadership competency, it will be present in some form or the other in every organization. We said that we should be able to create something which is very, very unique. We said if you take a Mahindra leader, he should be different from any other. So then we did a research on this whole thing. So what Rajesh was speaking about diagnosis, it's absolutely essential if you have got to really make this happen. So we create diagnosis and we created five characteristics of a Mahindra leader. We said Mahindra leaders should be able to manage fear and leverage failure. Then we said that they should be multipliers. Right? They should be multiplier of talent, they should be multiplier of customer expectations, they should be able to put mindfulness in place, they should be able to have a whole brain thinking, and finally we said they should be able to build trust. This whole thing has been integrated together in this whole program called Reflective Conversation. And then we said, realized that if you have got to really make this happen, we need to put a system in place. Therefore, you put an ecosystem in place. Therefore, transfer of learning cannot happen if there's an ecosystem. And you create an impact across the organization if you're able to ensure that the whole organization is blended into the whole thing. And then we realized another agenda for top companies for leaders to work for was the women leaders. We said diversity, we are very good. If you take our diversity ratio, they are one of the best. But from a gender ratio, we realized that the world associated diversity with gender. And the host of Women Think programs, and we realized in our research, we did a complete research that Women Think really does not work. You've got to put the whole thing through a structured 3-year program. And that is how we have created a complete Women Leaders program, and the ecosystem has been put in place. And finally, we said that if you've got to create transfer and learning, then you need to have an architecture. And this is something which we have copyrighted it. So we said that you can have programs which are organization driven, you can have programs which are employee driven. You can have it for a set of individual people and set of collective people. Then we said, can we dive deep into the whole thing as to what are things that we are doing well and what are the things that we have got to really do well. And we realized that gamification, a beehive approach to learning, like you take a honeybee, queen bee, then you have got the entire bee this thing. So we said, if you take that and transfer it to the organization, can we have several beehives across the organization? And therefore, who will be the queen bee to ensure that you create this ecosystem? And to make this happen, we look for partners who would help us in terms of creating gamification in various academies. We're looking for simulated learning. We have actually got Facebook at work. Right? We are front-ending them for a big experiment in India as to how do you translate an external social media into an internal organization and create communities of practice, right? And we feel that doing all these things, we will be able to contribute in a very big way to building of an admired brand, because the way we do things, the way we create learning, the way we create leaders, and the way our leaders work, and the way we contribute to building a purpose-driven organization will be something that will create a big impact. And this would not be possible if we do not have the complete ecosystem in place. And that is where our confidence in Mahindra Leadership University as an agent and tool to change and bring transformation to the organization will be crucial and critical. Thank you.